This is commonly happening in sports, such as martial arts, or riding hobbies like skateboarding, and doing tricks 50 meters above the ground on a motocross. But it can also happen to an innocent kid who just runs out of balance, and to the next kid who trips over the first kid. Knocked out teeth, or teeth avulsion, accounts for up to 16% of dental injuries, and is the number one cause of a significant decrease in handsomeness and prettiness in society. Although it seems trivial, tooth avulsion is one of the most serious dental injuries that needs prompt treatment for the best chance of outcome. Avulsion of primary tooth. If the avulsed tooth is not a permanent one, do not replant it, as it can disturb the eruption of a permanent tooth. Monitor the patient closely so the permanent tooth can grow smoothly. Missing avulsed tooth. In cases where the tooth cannot be found anywhere, we need to make sure using an X-ray device that the tooth is not intruded or inserted into the alveolar bone. The missing tooth can be replaced by a dental implant. For the intruded tooth, if it is not re-erupting by itself, it may need orthodontic repositioning or even surgery. When the avulsed tooth can be found after the accident, you have 30 to 60 minutes before the periodontal ligament, or PDL, becomes non-viable. Locate the tooth and pick it on its crown, the visible area when in mouth. If it's dirty, rinse it with a hypertonic solution, such as milk or saline solution. After that, the patient or another person around should attempt to put back the tooth in its socket immediately. The patient then bites on the gauze or a piece of cloth to keep it in place. If it is not possible at the time, maybe the patient is unconscious. Find a clean storage filled with saline solution or milk or saliva. When the patients or people around are not sure how to reinsert the tooth, the quickest option is to put the avulsed tooth inside the cheeks to preserve it with saliva. In each situation, bring the patient and the tooth to the emergency clinic and visit a dentist as soon as possible. In a good condition, without any concern of head trauma or complications in the patient, the dentist proceeds to check the patient's mouth and clean the area from debris. If a gingival laceration is present, after local, preferably non-vasoconstricting anesthesia is administered. A suture needs to be applied. Any fracture on the jawbone or alveolar bone is managed first. Then, the doctor places the tooth if it hasn't been, or verifies the replanted location and integrity using radiography. A flexible splint, such as wire or fishing line, is applied to adjacent teeth to stabilize the avulsed tooth while the tissue and bones around it heal. The splinting period can last more than 2 weeks. Painkillers, antibiotics, and anti-tetanus injections may be administered if needed. During the splinting period, the patient should eat soft food and avoid biting on the replanted tooth. The splinted tooth also cannot be brushed normally, and at the same time, the splint itself will collect more plaque and food debris. So, a mouth rinse is prescribed to prevent gingivitis or gum inflammation. After the splint is applied, an adult needs to have a root canal procedure in 2 weeks to remove the infected tissue and clean the canals. For immature permanent teeth in children, if the root is not formed yet, natural revascularization of the pulp space can still happen and lead to root development, but it needs to be monitored closely in case necrosis or inflammation appears, which necessitates the root canal treatment immediately. The long-term outcome of dental trauma depends on many factors of each individual, but the most important one is how long it took from the time of the avulsion to receiving treatment. If more than 60 minutes pass, even if replanted successfully, the prognosis of the tooth is not going to be good. The root on the gum can be resorbed, and the PDL on the tooth can experience necrosis. For any treatment received by the patient, regular visits to the dentist or endodontist are required. Prevention. Now, how to prevent tooth avulsion in the first place? While a fall on your face is accidental and difficult to account for, other activities that involve strong impact to the head, such as boxing, rugby, or American football, should require the player to use mouth guards and a face mask. It also protects the area around the teeth, like the jawbone, gum, and temporomandibular joint. So, the next time you walk onto the field or in the ring, use one on your mouth to protect your handsomeness.